Okay, so tip number one is set a specific goal and date. It has to have a date and it needs to be specific. And it needs to be kind of a close enough date to where it's attainable and not too far where it just gives you kind of too much freedom, right? So if I say I want to lose 10 pounds by July, well, that's like 6 months, you know. No, you need to set a date. And because we are trying to stay fit and accountable during the holidays, she suggested to have either January 2nd or January 15th as your date. Now, specific goals. It's one thing to sit here and say, I want to lose weight, or I want to be stronger, or I want to lose inches. But if we can't, if we can't measure our progress, how do we know we even met our goals, right? So for example, specific goal would be, I want to lose 7 pounds by January 1st or by January 15th. Specific, and it has a date. Or I want to drop my body fat by 1% by January 15th. Or I want to lose 10 inches. I'm going to exercise 7 days a week or 6 days a week. I'm going to eat healthy. Something that you can track weekly or daily, and definitely track by when that date comes. Okay, number two, accountable. It makes such a difference when you are accountable to someone, either a community group on Facebook or just someone, but it has to be someone that's gonna hold you accountable. It can't be someone who's gonna let you kind of slack off. It needs to be someone who's gonna tell you how it is, like, hey, you're messing up. You need to get back on it. It needs to be someone who's going to push you and who's going to hold you accountable, not someone who's going to be like, oh, it's okay, girl. You know, you can get back in it tomorrow. So choose someone who you know is going to be strict with you and is going to hold you accountable. And also choose someone who themselves are reliable and are consistent. You also don't want to choose an accountability buddy who kind of falls off, you know, the face of the earth here and there. So that's number two, accountability. Number three, write down and think about what will you sacrifice. Anytime we have big goals that we're trying to attain, there has to be sacrifices. So, can it be less happy hours from now until January 1st? Now, we're not saying, you know, be miserable and, you know, lock yourself in your door and, you know, throw yourself a pity party, but there does need to be some sacrifices. Could it be less dinner nights? Maybe if you and your husband or your family go out to dinner 3 times a week, can it be just two? Or if you guys go to dinner two times a week, can it be just once a week? Or can it be that you're gonna sacrifice 1 or 2 hours on Sunday or Saturday to meal prep so that during the week you have your food ready and you're ready to rock and roll and you're not tempted to stop by and get some junk, or you're not tempted to go into the teacher's lounge and get whatever crap they're serving in there. If you have food already prepped and ready to go, you are less likely to be tempted and to fall off track during the week. And it saves so much time. I know that we think an hour or two during the weekend, it's a big sacrifice, but it's going to save you so much time during the week. All right. And another sacrifice, can it be, so a lot of holiday parties are going to start popping up at your jobs. Companies are going to start to have luncheons or potlucks. Can you be the one to bring something healthier, or can you take your lunch that day and just have your lunch, right? You don't have to explain yourself to people. Just do you. If you know there are some parties that you really want to, can you say, okay, you know what? I won't go to this one and I won't go to this one, but I'll go to this one because it's my best friend and it means so much to me, and I'll go to this one, right? That's what I do sometimes whenever during the weekends. Like, I'm like, well, I'm not going to have cocktails this weekend and this one, but, you know, I'm going to meet this friend on this day, so I'll save myself for that weekend. Sacrifices. All right, number four. What program and meal plan will you follow to help your goals? So that meal plan and that program that you chose has to help you in your specific goals. Some people might not want to lose weight. Some people might want to get stronger or do 10 more pull-ups by the end of the year. Whatever goals you are, choose something that's going to help you in your goals. Now, It needs to be something you're gonna stick to it. It can't be something you hate and you dread because you're not going to do it. You're not gonna do it. Now it has to be something like, for it has to be something new that you haven't been doing. So for example, if you're used to high impact HIIT trainings, workouts, maybe you can do some low impact workout. Or if you're used to working out at home, maybe you can start running. Or if you're a gym freak, maybe you can try some workout programs. It needs to be something new because it needs to shock your body. It needs to challenge your body again. Our bodies get, you know, adapted pretty quickly to what we do. Even though, you know, it might still be hard for us and we might still sweat up a storm, but our bodies get adjusted to what we're doing pretty easily. So you might not be losing as much weight anymore, burning as many calories anymore, because your body's like, oh, this again. Yeah, we did. I know this. So it needs to be something new. It needs to be something you're going to enjoy, but also kind of have that love-hate relationship. So many of my workouts, like Insanity Max 30, Asylum Volume 2, which I'm doing right now, it's a love-hate relationship, right? So I hate it because it challenges me and it pushes me. And I love it because it challenges me and it pushes me. But I don't hate it so much that I dread working out and that I don't get it done. Okay. I think that was it, but those are great tips for you guys to stay accountable, and for me too, stay accountable. And again, either lose weight, which can be possible. I know many people think, oh, the holidays, Thanksgiving, Christmas, tamales, impossible, I gotta gain weight. No, you don't have to. There's ways, if we do everything you possibly can to stay committed during the week, you're eating as healthy as you can, you're doing your workouts, come Thanksgiving, even if you indulge and you enjoy the heck out of that day, you're not gonna gain weight, because you are eating healthy and working out all these every other day. So with Thanksgiving coming up, which is our first holiday coming up, can you stay committed from now until next Thursday with your meal plans, with your workouts? Because I promise, if you do, come Thanksgiving, you can indulge without feeling guilty, because you're like, hey, I've been working my butt off, I've been sticking to my meal plan, you know, and I've been doing my workouts, I'm gonna indulge today without guilt. And the next day, you might have some leftovers here and there, but you get back on track. And then the next one would be, is there a holiday party coming up that you really wanna go to? Well, then do your best before that to stay on track. All right, guys, so I hope those tips helped. Don't use the holidays as an excuse to gain weight. I know, like, the average American gains, I don't know, 5 to 10 pounds or something like that. But that's because I think we use the holidays as an excuse. Like, well, the holidays are here, time to gain weight. Like, do you want to wake up on January 1st feeling proud of yourself? And, or do you want to wake up on January 1st feeling like a busted can of biscuits? It's your choice. You're the only one who can make that choice. Love you guys. Thanks for watching.